Just a couple more. I know Mukunda had his hand up. But if you keep your comments very, very brief, you can get a couple of more second generation speakers. You can come forward. You have to come. If you speak, you have to come here and speak. Yes, come here. Mukunda is a, no, I hate to say it like this, but when I went to Mayapur one year, I was praying, Krishna, I would like to have some big Bengali devotees in Atlanta. And he was the very first Bengali devotee that came to Atlanta, so I'm very proud of him. Haribo!
Actually, I don't know anything, but I hear from one of the most different devotees who summarize the glories of Srila Prabhupada. Just I want to speak a few words about Panihati festivals. You know, when Guru Maharaj becomes GBC, when Balabhar Prabhu and Gopinath Nityananda Prabhu as president and Balabhar Prabhu as vice president, they ask Guru Maharaj that, Maharaj, we have many Bengali devotees. Can we have one? So I was in Puja in Vrindavan. Guru Maharaj wrote me a letter that I want you to send to USA for experience. And I still have in the letter. So I replied to Guru Maharaj that I am a brahmachari, I am a Puja in Vrindavan. And there is no passport office. So what should I do? He says, go to some other temples where you can arrange your passport and you can continue your service. So I went to Ahmedabad, Bhagavad Jashama Vinandan Prabhu, and I got my passport. And there is some reason, Nani Ashram. So Guru Maharaj told me to come to Calcutta, work with the Bhakti Nagar Maharaj, with Namatra, Gauranga Swami. He was an amateur teacher. That time he was a commissary, so I worked with him. And I applied for my passport, so everything happened. And then Guruva says, he was in charge in Thailand. Guruva told me, Thailand, Bhakti Maharaj won some devotees. He said to Sudarshan, but Sudarshan won only rice and dal, moong dal and rice, nothing else. So he sent me there, then I walked there, then finally Guru Maharaj told me, I want you to come to USA, work at Atlanta Temple. So he, in Calcutta Temple, there was a devotee, Khetra Kapoor. He wrote a letter to him that take Mukunda to US Embassy. So he took me, then after I got visa, then I don't have money, so Guru Maharaj in Madras, and he called Kusutu Maharaj to take Mukunda and get his tickets and go with the Pancharatna Prabhu. So Pancharatna Prabhu was coming in the proper disciple. Kusutu Maharaj, he took me to the pick up the tickets, and Rajan Prabhu would know that one of our God brothers. So we are on the way to airport, but some other we are late because to pick up the tickets, we don't have the money, this and that. And when we reach the airport, almost 30 minutes late. And they say, the flight is late. So some other one, when I arrived in India, they say, have you got any money? I said, I have only Indian rupees. They say, cannot let you in. But anyway, we will give you 7 days time to come for interview. Then we'll see. They sent the Parampara Prabhu to pick me up from New York. So he went for interview with me. First they interviewed me. I explained to the immigration officer what I do. And he said, I like to join Hare Krishna because they have free food, dancing, chanting, travel around the world. It's not your cost that Hare Krishna people provide everything. I want to join. I said, you're welcome. I asked the immigration officer, you're welcome. Then I say, anyone with you? Then Mukunda Prabhu and he explained, they say, okay, no problem. I have a visa only for 3 months. Each time for 4 months, okay, go. And then when I came here, I met Mukunda Prabhu, and Balwant Prabhu was speaking Indian. He knows many Indian people. So he used to take me to Indian people to make members, because financially that time very weak. And we had that big mortgage, big properties, and Mukunda Prabhu used to write the song to Murali Valley. That's how they, you know, they were maintained. And then I was working in Pujari. And one day, suddenly, George Prabhu was a cook. He gave me cheap rice in George. And our office was out there. I ran to the office, because Mukunda Prabhu was there all over Sankirtan. I said, Mukunda Prabhu, why today is a cheap rice, George? He said, today is funny happy. I said, I don't hear anything, no devotee, no glorification. And of course, you know, this is not Chaitanya's, you know, plan, not Chaitanya's plan. Then Mukunda Prabhu said, that's what we do. He's right here. He's smiling, he said, that's what we do. You know, because we don't know how to organize. Do you know how to? I suppose I'm from Calcutta, Mahapur, so we'll organize next year. So we want to have a little more funny happy festivals, so the devotees can come and enjoy the funny happy. So we don't have Dr. Dakra, we don't have deities to take. So what we did, we took Prabhupada, and small quality type, this quarter, to this finger for 3 times. We invite some Indian devotees in the congregation people. We had about 40, 50 people, and we cooked some cheap rice, different bread, so sweets. We had a lot of fun. Then Guru Maharaj came. I said, Guru Maharaj, we start funny, do you mind to come? He said, no, I love festivals. I will come. So by his expertise, we learn how to organize, because I did a paniyati, a way to paniyati, but I don't know how to organize festival, but I like to have a little more, you know, like a festival type, what we hear from Chaitanya Chaitanya, how Nityananda Prabhu, and he told Raghunatha Goswami, the feet of the Vaishnavas, Brahmanas. So that's happened. And since that time, since 85, Guru Maharaj is coming and he organized. Right now we see hundreds of thousands of devotees come from different parts of the world, enjoy these festivals and chant Jai Satyananda Gaur Hari. And this is the glory of Panihati and this new Panihati. And of course, one request my brother sent me, request to all the devotees here. He says, please announce that from the temple that he's in charge of the original Panihati. He's organizing the Panihati festival for many years now. And he recently, on the last Gaur Purnima, he took sannyas. His name is Bhakti Nityananda Swami. And he told me that Western devotees, especially in Atlanta, Guru Maharaj is using varieties of dry fruits and nuts. But in India, they don't have that much varieties of dried fruits and nuts. So he said, any devotees like to do some donation. He doesn't want money, but he wants the dried fruits which he can save and can use for the Panihati festival, for the pleasure of Nithananda and Raghunatha Goswami and the pleasure of Dr. Chaitanya. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hey, thank you. Is this about ready for our tea for everything?
Yeah.
Okay, and I do apologize to all the other Prabhupada disciples, Grandpa, Peter Kulu, Kakula Kulu, that we didn't have a chance for all of you to speak today.
Leela Avatar
Kulu, I'm sure the other ones, so please forgive us, and next year we'll try to do more. But to the second generation, we really are depending on you to get the real spirit of this festival, carry it forward, and I thank you all so much.